after the major pest, moves toward the minor pest, that is the pest of the cotton, is the Dysdercus singulatus, commonly known as the red cotton stainer or red cotton bug. First of all, systematic position. Class Insecta, order Hemiptera, that commonly the members comes under the Hemiptera, known as the bugs. Family Pyrocoridae, genus Dysdercus, and the species Singulatus. This is the Dysdercus singulatus or the red cotton stainer. The host plants where they attack, along with the cotton, lady's finger, maize, sorghum, jute, and other malvaceous plants. Now, moves toward the marks of identification. The names, they are generally red in color with black and white dots. Look at that here, that black dots and the white dots on the abdominal region, which are observed in the nymphal stage. In case of the adults, they are elongated, dorsoventrally flattened, slender, crimson red in color with white bands across the abdomen. These are the wings which are observed, and just below the wings, the abdomen where white bands are present as that of the nymphal stage. Head, no doubt, that is a red in color, both in the nymphal as well as the adult stage, with a white collar here. Abdomen is black and the four wings have two black dots. These are the four wings. Here two black spots are present, or the dots are present in the four wings of the adult. The membranous portion of the four wings and the antennae are black in color. Here this is the four wing and terminal part of the four wing, which is black in color. Both nymph and adults, they suck the sap of that plant, and for sucking, the special modification of the mouth parts are present. That name is the piercing and the sucking type of the mouth parts. Moves toward the next point is the life cycle. In the spring season, the bugs becomes much more active, and after mating, the female lays about 100 to 130 eggs in the soil or nearby area of the host plant. The eggs are spherical and bright yellow in color, which is laid singly or in a cluster, which consists of around 10 to 40 eggs in a group. After the incubation period, around 7 to 8 days, the nymphs, which are hatched and start to feed on the growing shoots of the cotton plant. Nymph, which is looks like to the adult, only the size differentiation and the reproductive structure which differentiate that nymph and the adult, while color pattern, their shape, as well as the feeding habitat is the same, is of the larva and the adult, and hence that larva, which known as the nymph. They start to feed on the cotton plant after hatching. Freshly hatched nymphs are pale orange in color, but later on turn into the red color with black and white dots already discussed. There are a total 5 nymphal stages are present. They continuously feeds on that plant and suck the sap, and after around the 49 to 89 days, that nymph, which transform into the adult. The female adult generally larger than the male. After the life cycle, just we focus the nature of the damage. Both adults and nymphs, as the piercing and the sucking type of the mouth parts, they suck the cell sap from the leaves and the green balls of the cotton and stain the lint. The damaged tissue are colonized by the microorganisms that causes ball rot and discoloration. And that microorganisms when colonized, that is the bacteria whose name is the Nematospora gossypii, enter the site of injury where they suck the sap by these adults and the nymph of the red cotton bug and stain the fiber. That Nematospora gossypii whose colony which is continuously increases in that site of the injury and due to which the red stain which is appear. As the severe attack of the adult and the nymph of the red cotton bug, it causes the ball abortion, premature opening and early shed of the balls. The seeds produced are smaller with reduced oil content and lower germination rate. These seeds are not fit for the sowing. A high infestation can cause a severe loss in the quality due to stain lint. Now, how we can control that pest? First is the mechanical method. By simple the hand picking and killing of that pest in the kerosinized water as the population is still small. The infected leaves or the balls can be shaken in the water, that especially the kerosinized water, and due to which we can at certain extent control the pest. The moistened cotton seeds should be hang up at different places in the field where bugs congregate and they may get killed in the kerosinized water. Next method is the cultural method. Remove the alternative host plants and other wild plants of the Malvaceae family which also effective to control such type of the pest. Remove and destroy all the standing cotton plants as soon as the cotton has been picked up. And we know about that. After the cotton collected from the field, the many farmers, they remove the all standing that cotton plant and burn it in the field. Deep plowing, which also effective to expose the buried eggs to sunlight and the predators. The next method, that is the chemical methods, where the pest can be controlled by spraying the crop by using 0.1% BSC, 0.02% endrin, 0.05% malathion, 0.1% DDT, or many other chemicals which are available in the market. Dusting the crop with 10% BSC is also effective to control these pests. Thank you.